I will talk about mixed initiative planning and execution for multi-drones in search and rescue mission. This work is framed in the context of the Sherpa project, and this project is about the development of an infrastructure, a mixed ground and aerial robotic platform that should support search and rescue activities in the Alpine environment. What is peculiar of this project is that the operator of this team of robot is a human rescuer that is not dedicated to the platform, is called the Busy Genius and works in the team with this robot and should be able to provide instructions to the robots in a very sketchy but effective way. So the feature of this domain are the following. We have a rescuer that plays the role of the operator of this set of drones. Those are heterogeneous team of robots, small scale UAV and long endurance, high altitude and high payload UAV that are involved in the scene. The operator is co-located and not dedicated to the platform, can be involved in other tasks. So there is a implicit and limited communication with this platform and could interact at different level of abstraction with them, could sometimes directly teleoperate the platform or sometimes just give some abstract instruction to them, to the team or to the single robots. So it's very challenging domain where we need a human-robot interaction and from the robot side some kind of adjustable autonomy because when the human is not directly involved in the control, the robot should be able to behave by themselves in an autonomous manner. Actually, the picture is much more complicated because there is also the rescue team involved. So there is a busy genius that is responsible for the control of this team of robots, but there are also humans involved in the search, and the robot should help in this context. We distinguish between two different scenarios: the winter scenario, where basically the mission is to help the rescuers in an avalanche during in the context of an avalanche. So the area is small, we consider low altitudes, and the mission should be fast. So basically, within 15 minutes, the probability of surviving drops. And in this case, so it's very important a fast and direct interaction with these drones. Otherwise, in the summer scenario, we have instead the task is to searching for missing persons in an extended area. In this case, there is time to plan the mission, to replan the mission, because the mission can last days. And then in this case, both co-located and remote interaction is relevant. As for the human, the equipment, so we, since the human is involved in the scene, we need some wearable devices. We decided for several kind of devices from the XSense MWN Biotech suite that provides motion capture for gesture recognition, headset for voice interaction, this thalamic armband that now we are trying to exploit because it is much more agile than that suite. And then, of course, a tablet or something similar, microphone band to monitor the human state because also this is an issue in the project. Basically, from a very high-level point of view, we have a human that can interact in a mode multimodal manner with this multi-robot team, then the human may directly command a single robot or directly the team. So it's needed a module in the middle that allows for this mixed initiative control. And then it is different control modes should be enabled from the autonomous to direct teleoperation, and then everything in the middle at different level of abstractions. So we have a problem of having the human in the loop, and the intervention of the human should be able should be incorporated into this planning loops at different level of abstraction from task, path, and trajectory replanning. this is basically the multimodal architecture, since we have a different way of providing commands to the robots, we need to fuse all this information, and indeed we can provide gesture, speech, we need to synchronize and then interpret this. This is a fusion fusion problem, and then we end up with a kind of interpretation of the human state, and then we have to close the loop of the control. I show here a video, let's see if it works, where we can see this direct interaction of human. This is in a laboratory, so the human can command these three drones. Those are small drones. They can provide commands with gestures, only gestures, or only voice. Can directly select one of the drone and then provide instruction to the drone. Can provide instruction with also numerical information. Can provide instruction about what kind of search strategy one drone can should provide. Can also point towards one of the drone. This is for co-located interaction. And indeed, in this case, what we need is a very, very fast trajectory and path replanning, because every time that the human provides some commands to the robot, the robot should be immediately replanned. Otherwise, also the readability of what the human the robot is doing is completely lost. So here we deploy very, very simple trajectory planning mechanisms that are basically based on fourth order spline concatenation that preserve continuous acceleration. And then as for the path planner, we use RRT star motion planner algorithms, but we may also use other kind of algorithm. What is very important is that the technique are fast in this context. And then we try also to minimize the planning so that whenever the deviation, so the human can provide some intervention at this level, trying to avoid somehow the replanning activity. So it is possible to deviate from the trajectory, and a kind of interval, a region, an envelope is provided that is adaptive with respect to the environment. And whenever the robot goes out of this envelope, replanning activity starts. And actually, we also associate, in order to give to the human the situation awareness of this deviation, we associate a feedback that can advise the human, can give to the human the sensation of this deviation from the trajectory. This is an example where we have deviation without replanning, and a force feedback provides this information of the deviation, and whenever there is a replanning, a new path is provided, as if a new road is defined in the environment. We try to use this in the context of the Sherpa, when instead of the feedback, we provide a vibration with that arm bend. So here we have an example of another kind of interaction in a simulated environment. In this case, during a task, the human can open the hand, and this hand open works as if this is a kind of a virtual joystick. So the trajectory can somehow be planned, and then the human can adjust this trajectory or directly teleoperate, having this feedback with this arm bend. From the task level, so this is the low level control loop that we have closed, but we have to close also the higher level control loop, and then we need somehow to to plan the overall rescue mission, we refer to the classical guidelines for search. We first have to define the area of search, then sub-areas are associated with high probability of finding victims, then each sub-area should be associated with a specific search pattern. There are, each pattern are, have some features depending on the dimension and depending on the also the kind of search that it's can be provided in the area, and then the mission can start. And in our case, we want that those are the description of the feature of this search path. We want that the user is able to provide in an easy way to define this mission in an easy way through a tablet interface. This is another modality. That is possible to provide, and we want also that the user is able to the busy genius is able to change this mission online. So we defined this interface, so it is possible to manually define the area and then associate manually some search pattern. But of course, we want that the system. This is an example, a real example. So we can somehow represent this is the dam of a portion of Sardinia, and then we import this in this game engine that is actually our interface, Unity 3D game engine that is actually used for as an interface for us, both for simulation but also for real mission. And then this is an example where we can define paths and define search areas, and then directly completely define a mission for the drone and change the perspective of the drone. And then so we can use somehow simulation in a real environment or directly work directly in the real environment in this manner. What we want to achieve is so we want that the operator should be able to partially specify this mission. So for example, specifying only the areas but not the search pattern, or leaving for example to the task level supervisor capability of assigning the area to the drones and assigning also the search pattern. So in order to do this, we developed this layered architecture. For us, since we need something that is very fast, we started with so the design is based on BDI systems. We exploit PRS, basically open PRS by Ingrand et al, that is also directly connected with, so can be easily integrated with a hierarchical task planner. This is HATP, and then this combination for us is pretty effective, because it allows us to plan and execute in a fast manner, and then the BDI system is able to incorporate the human intervention and then provide replanning in a fast manner. Of course, this depends also on how the planning problem is defined. Basically, our planning problem in this context is pretty simple. Is only about search areas and assigning search task to the drones, the search tasks that are not defined by the human. So we introduce a simple cost model. We know that it's possible to do better. There is all the Bayesian search theory available here, but we simplify just because we are interested to arrive at a first prototype that close also the upper loop of of the system. So what we obtain then is that this hierarchical task plan, so it's a shop-like plan that is compatible also with the task decomposition policy of PRS, can be exploited in order to somehow instantiate what is missing from the human partial plan, and then we tested the overall system in a simulated Alpine scenario. It is a very, very simple and preliminary test that what we provided here. Also in this case, this is Unity 3D. We assume that the robot is endowed with some human detection algorithm. This is we have a human detection algorithm, and of course in this case we assume that it's perfect, so that whenever the target is in the field of view of the drone from 30 meters, this we assume that this is detected, and then we compared different way of controlling, so the performance in terms of number of victims detected with the manual control, fully autonomous control, and mixed initiative control. Also the interface, we have designed the interface provides some information back to the human. This is just to give an idea of the kind of view that the human may have. This is a different interface from the one that we have seen before. The big screen provides the information about the controlled drone. Somehow the other one is smaller. Whenever we have more drones, we have to decide which of the how to provide this information. So also the design of the interface is important in this case. So from the first setup, this is a very simple preliminary example. We already have additional, we are carrying out additional result in this context. So we can see that if the distribution of the victims in the environment are somehow as expected, so if the hypothesis on the distribution of the victims in the environment is respected, then of course the autonomous systems provides some performance that are comparable with the mixed initiative, and the mixed initiative advantage starts to be emphasized whenever the initial hypothesis start to become wrong. We also collected data about the kind of interventions that we had in these different scenarios. And we can see that this the joystick usage is enhanced with the complexity of the environment, but usually we have just a small adjustment with minimal replanning, and then so low level and task replanning is somehow reduced. Okay, this is basically, this concludes my talk. It was basically the opportunity for me to present this scenario, to present this this architecture. Of course, testing is very preliminary. We have to extensively test this framework with more complex example. We are going to test this framework outdoor with real drone. This will happen before the summer, hopefully. And then we have to integrate a more complex delegation system in place of this multi-robot supervisor that is just a prototype for us, that was used for us in order to close the loop also at the upper level of the architecture. And then, of course, also the search should be more developed. We have to integrate Bayesian search theory in this strategy. Okay, I conclude here my talk.